Friends, hope you are doing good. In this video, as I told in your previous video, I'm going to teach you about using the extrude function. So in our previous videos we were dealing with about 2D sketches and 2D drawings. In this video we'll be dealing with 3D sketches and 3D drawings. So let's get into this video. As I taught you in your previous videos, just go to a sketch. Choose your sketch plane. In this case I will be choosing the top plane and give sketch. So you will be prompted on the top plane. So now, similar to what we did in the 2D sketching, just choose any of the following 2D sketches. You can use a rectangle, you can use a circle, you can even use an ellipse. You can use anything you want. So for complexity factor we'll use from simple we'll go. So first we'll use the rectangle. So just click on the rectangle icon, select one end point and specify the next end point. So you are having your rectangle here. Now double click on the dimensions and give the dimensions of the following rectangle. So I'm giving here as 100 and here the length to be 200. So this is a 200 cross 100 rectangle. So make sure that your sketch is a closed one. So if your sketch is a closed one, you'll be getting a colored box like this. I mean, the sketch which you had made would be in a colored. If it is an open section, for example, if it is an open section, you won't be having that colored segment and you'll be having that open points as red dots. So I'm controlling Z it. So now as this is a closed structure, we can extrude this. So once the sketch is complete, click on the tick mark. Now you have your sketch in your workspace. So extruding is very simple actually. So just go on, click extrude icon. So since there is only one sketch in the workspace, Creo automatically recognizes the sketch and it extrudes the feature. So there are some different types of extrusion actually. So the first one is a single side extrusion. You can just go and specify the value of the depth here and it changes your extruded block. The second type is, you can go to the options, click on blind, and this one is used for extruding in both the directions at the same time. You can even click and drag using your mouse button, or you can manually enter a value. So this is two side extrusion option which is available in Creo. So you can use it to extrude in both the sides. The next one is that symmetrical extrusion. So as we did in this blind, just go on, I'll select none. So it has been deleted, so only one side extrusion is available. Now you can go and click on the symmetrical icon so that Creo automatically recognizes and it places your block symmetric to the plane on which the sketch has been drawn. So if you give a depth as 75, for example, I will give it as 80. So 40 will be on the top side of the plane and 40 will be on the bottom side of the plane. So this icon, extrude as a symmetry on both sides, is used for this purpose. So the next one is extrude to the plane. I'll come to it afterwards. So this is a basic extrude option actually. So I'll click cancel so that I have my sketch back. For exploring the third icon, you need to create a reference plane. Creating a reference plane is as easy. Just click on the plane icon in the workspace and choose which plane you need to create as a reference. So I'll be creating the top plane as my reference. So once you click on that, once you click on that, you can move the plane to whatever distance you want. I'll give the translation distance as 100 mm and click on OK. So as you can see, this is a base top plane and this is a reference plane which we created from the base top plane. So now we have our sketch. So go on to extrude. You can click on the sketch which you had previously drawn. So now we'll go and explore our third option. This option actually extrudes up to a certain point or a curve or a plane to which you choose. So select this option and select the plane or a curve up to which you need to extrude. In this case, I am selecting this plane. This is my target plane. So if I click, the object will be extruded up to this plane. So if I click this, you can see the object has been extruded up to this plane. So this is actually basic extrude command action. Basic extrude command. One of the extrude command is can be classified into two broad categories actually. One is a solid extrude and the next one is surface extrude. So regarding the surface extrude, I'll go back to the same. I'll remove it. So you have a we have our sketch here. We have our sketch here. And you can see these two options. One is extrude as a solid, the next one is extrude as a surface. So if you click extrude as a surface and you give a value, hide the planes. So you give a value and give tick. So you can see that your sketch has been extruded as a surface. So there won't be any solid infill inside, only the outer walls will be extruded. So this is a type of extruding a surface actually. So all the things which we saw in a solid extrude comes under this also. You can extrude the surface up to a definite plane, or you can give a definite depth for a plane. So everything you can do in the same. So similar to this, if you want to delete this extrude, just click on the extrude, right click, and you can delete it, you can hide it, you can again edit it using this icon. You can edit the dimensions of this sketch using this icon. You can even suppress it from the design. So now I'll delete it. I'll also delete my sketch. And I'll create a new sketch with top plane as a reference plane. So now I'll create a circle. I can create so concentric circles. So I'll use concentric circle, click on the point, first I need to create a circle with a dimension of 100, then I need to create a concentric circle, so I can use this dimension to be 120 so that the thickness becomes 10. So now this is a circular profile. You can either extrude this particular sketch which is inside as a separate sketch, I mean you can extrude it as a separate cylinder, or else you can extrude the sketch part which you design now as a ring which you see on the screen. So you can enter the depth of it and it gets updated as well. So also you can just extrude these two lines separately by clicking on thicken sketch. So as you can see, the two lines have been thickened and has been extruded as two concentric circles. How we don't need this right now. So this is an extruding a circle. So now just simple, that's the module which you want to learn in extrude actually. So extruding anything is much easier. Only one thing you need to keep in mind is the sketch which you define has to be a closed one. Open sketches cannot be extruded. So if the sketch is like this and if you give OK, the sketch will be there but you cannot extrude it. Okay, right, you can see here the sketch cannot be extruded. So how to make sure whether your sketch is a closed or open sketch? Just while doing your sketch, you can ensure that these two dots are connected. So I'll just so when your sketch is a closed sketch, you'll have a colored area of the sketch which is closed. So now you can extrude it as such. So this is a basic of sketching, and I mean sketching and extruding. So two things which you need to keep in mind in during extruding is that the one point is your sketch has to be a closed one, and the next one is your sketch can be a solid or a surface. So in my next video I'll teach you how to use revolve option and sweep option. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.